17 regular season conference titles and 2 national championships. With 17 more wins, he will become the all-time winningest coach in college basketball. But this year, Dean Smith's Tar Heels have done something they have never done in the 44 years of the conference. Start ACC play at 0-3. Tonight, their neighbors from the East, NC State, also try to get into the ACC win column. The Pack and Heels coming up next. Fans expected at the Dean Smith Center tonight for this game between NC State and the Tar Heels of North Carolina. Both clubs looking for their first ACC win of the year. Hi, everybody. I'm Tim Brandt along with Billy Packer. Glad to have you along for what we think will be an interesting ball game. It is interesting that in the previous 31 years, I think everybody expected or anticipated North Carolina to be fighting for the ACC title or maybe even the national title, and here they are now winless.
Well, Tim, over the course of that period of time, they had some great talent. And I think that's the only difference between being at the top of the league and fighting for your life down near the bottom.
No question about it. Lost some great talent to the NBA guys going out early.
Well, not to make any excuses for this program or any others that were affected the same way, but take a look at McGinnis, Wallace, and Stackhouse. That would be a senior threesome here on this ball club. They wouldn't be battling for the bottom of the league. They'd be battling for number one in the nation, maybe be a dominant team in the nation.
Coming into the season, Dean Smith said, because we are thin, the bench is short, we have to stay healthy. So what happens? Vince Carter has that hip pointer. An injury usually keeps a player out 3 to 4 weeks, but he's going to go tonight.
He is, but it certainly won't be as effective. And you pointed out, Tim, not only is this lack of depth hurt you in ball games, it hurts you in a practice situation. We saw Clemson tonight with that great depth that they have. It makes for a very competitive practice.
NC State's not getting a whole lot of points, Billy. They've got to score more to have a shot.
Well, they do, but it's very difficult to set up an offense when you have no inside game. Todd Fuller goes to the pros. Obviously, as a senior last year, he was their inside presence. So teams that play them this year play them for the perimeter shot, and they've got to handle the ball well to get some of those off.
All right, we're just about set. The fans are getting all set here at the Dean Smith Center. We'll have Carolina and NC State after these messages, and the lineups coming up next. NC State comes in with a record of 8-4, 0-3 in the conference. North Carolina 9-4, and 0-3. In the conference here at the Dean Smith Center. They're just set to go. Let's take a look at the starting lineups for tonight's game. For NC State, Danny Strong starts at four. Damon Thornton, young freshman at center. Then comes Harrison Hyatt. Those two are the scorers. And Oshua Benjamin, who's a talent but has been somewhat inconsistent. Starting lineup for North Carolina, as you look at Dean Smith in his 36th year. Antoine Jamison, of course, and Adamola Okalaja. Serge Wicker at the middle, Jamon Williams at guard, and Ed Cota, the freshman from Brooklyn, New York, starts at the point. We'll be back with the opening tip for this game at the Dean Smith Center after this message from Bud Light. North Carolina and NC State looking for their first wins in the ACC this year. Herb Sendick in his first year has changed the attitude from frustration to hope. He got 5 early commitments, so he's trying to fill some gaps. And then, of course, the dean of them all, Dean Smith, in his 36th year as head coach of the Tar Heels. It's been some run.
Kind of interesting. This is the 6th coach from NC State that Dean Smith has gone up against.
Started off with Everett Case.
Carolina leads this series 117-69 and has won 8 of the last 10 against State here in Chapel Hill. The two clubs split their 2 regular season games last year. Dick Vaccaro, David Elliott, and Carl Hess, the officials. The crowd is ready. We're ready. Let's tip it up.
Tim, I think both the crowd and this team will have to get off to an early start, that being Carolina, to show that they are emotionally back from what's happened, what's been written about them, talked about them in the last week or so.
Billy, what about their confidence after the success they've had in past years and now what's taking place?
Yeah, it's really a gut check for a young ball club, and it is a young team.
Shot clock at 15. This is Jamon Williams.
Pretty nice man-to-man defense by NC State at this point.
Cota can't get it to go down. last touch by Jamison, NC State ball.
Is everybody talking, and rightfully so, about Tim Duncan this year and what he's doing? But Jamison, when you look at the stats, not only in the national but the conference stats, Jamison right there with him, except in wins, which is the number one category.
Clemson and Wake Forest having terrific years. Clemson already has another win in the bank tonight. Big win up at Cole Fieldhouse.
Winning on the road against other teams that are battling for upper end position is going to be huge in the league this year.
Thornton gets in some trouble. Benjamin gets it back. Now five on the shot clock. He fires and can't get it to drop.
Pretty good block out by Snicker, who has actually got about what looks like a foot and a half over Thornton in size.
Well, this foul is on Damon Thornton. He's an excellent athlete, playing out of position perhaps. He's a forward, but he's playing center by his force there.
Well, he's listed at 6'7". Snicker at about 7'2", but it looks like there's a good foot in regard to the difference in size.
And Bill, you can understand why he's had some foul troubles this year.
Sure. You give up that size, you get caught in a reaching situation, and it's very difficult.
This foul is on Jeremy Hyatt, his first. Second team foul for the Wolfpack, and it would be Carolina ball. Still no score. Can get on a roll too when he gets hot. Look out, remember that game he had against Duke last year where he hit 5 of 8 three-pointers and ended with 26 points.
And last year Williams had 2 double-figure scoring games, 14 and 10 against State.
Hyatt answers with 3.
Hyatt having quiet but excellent year for NC State.
He really is, Billy. Had his first double-double this past weekend against Maryland. Very versatile player.
Let's see if the Tar Heels start going inside this Zwicker some. Just going over the top of that defense. That's why they haven't tried.
Okalaja off the back of the rim. Zwicker gets it back.
They ought to go into him. Let him just feast in this defense being so small.
There's the jump hook by Zwicker over the smaller man, and it's now 5-3 Tar Heels.
Does a couple of things. First of all, gets that ball inside so the outside shot is going to be there, but really puts NC State in trouble in terms of the lack of size. Not much Thornton can do against him inside.
I will say this, after seeing NC State this past weekend, it's an undersized outman ball club, but they're very patient and work very hard. Still play with some confidence.
You can see they're trying to take time off the clock. One of the things that is different about this North Carolina club, they don't have the quickness of rotation.
Strong for 3. Gives the Pack a 1-point lead.
Carolina, in their great years, always had great defensive intensity out on the perimeter. This club just doesn't do that.
This foul is going to be against Carolina. Anton Jamison picks up his first.
Jamison needs to be very patient tonight because he knows how much he can get going on the inside if they just start looking for him.
16:55 to play first half. Tim Brandt and Billy Packer with you. NC State leads by 1.
For Steve Sendak, what you want to do in this game is to keep it as close as long as you can and then hope that the emotional strain on Carolina takes effect.
Strong tried to jam it and lost the handle.
What an offensive rebound so far for NC State against the bigger team.
And the team that leads the ACC in rebounding margin is Carolina. Big rebound by Strong. Hyatt had the shot and passed it up, so Benjamin drives with it.
Now the rebounds are going to be long because most of the shots are on the perimeter. So far, North Carolina's playing as if they're going to be short rebounds.
Back to Williams. This is for 3.
Sometimes you like the color of the guy's uniform, you know? Williams, 2 big games last year, as I pointed out, coming right back again.
Carolina by 3.
He was 5-for-14 from 3 against Maryland. Off to a much better start here. Oh, the pass is there. Harrison wide open.
Coda drives the lane and scores.
After you see Sendak, you want this team to slow down. You
don't want to get in a running situation. Normally against Carolina, where they don't have depth, it would be something you'd want to do to them, but Steve doesn't have the depth either.
Billy, that's what Clemson does so well. They'll melt the clock on you, then make you pay. Hyatt with a great baseline drive.
Nobody coming over from the weak side. Carolina forces your baseline. Normally that would never work.
Foul will be called on Danny Strom. 14:59 to go first half. It's Carolina by two. We'll be back after this message from Park West Auto Parts Stores. Vince Carter has checked into the ballgame for Carolina. A week and a half ago, he suffered that hip pointer, very painful injury. It causes trauma to the nerves and muscles just above the hip joint.
Tim, you hear about that a lot in football. You being a football guy, what, you know, you don't hear that much about it in basketball.
Well, you know, Bill Ford had one, if you remember. But in football, they wear the hip pads. In basketball, if they go down hard on that hip, obviously it's going to be a lot more painful because they don't have that area padded.
Let's see, with Carter in the ballgame, they pick up a little bit more the defensive rebounding, and he's quicker to the ball.
Thornton at the top of the key to Benjamin.
High, solid screens, trying to set somebody open for the jumper.
NC State used a lot of the clock, till they got to 10, and now they lose it.
Well, that interesting play, that ball hit off the referee, came back in bounds, so therefore it should have been out of bounds to NC State. He's got that reverse. Now he's got it. Okay.
Good call.
What happened here is that the ball was thrown by Okalaja, hit the referee who was out of bounds. That makes the play out of bounds. So the ball should have been turned over to NC State. Instead, the basket should not count. NC State's ball, and the time should come back on the clock.
I'm glad you wore your striped shirt tonight.
Well, No possession.
They aren't going to reset the clock.
There's no change of possession, but now I don't agree with that for the simple reason that time continued after the ball technically should have been dead out of bounds. So time should have been put back on the clock. Remember that there was actually a layup, so there was probably 1 or 2 seconds.
Get the shot off on time, but Harrison can't make it pay.
Hate to argue with the referees, but they missed on that one.
C.C. Harrison 0 for 2 tonight. They've got to get scoring out of him.
And if you're Carolina, you want to start this high-low inside game going as quickly as possible. There's no way they can handle quicker inside.
Carolina by 2, 13:56 to play first half. Shamon Williams now replaces Ed Cota, the freshman. So Shamon Williams will take over the point. Vince Carter just before the game while he was warming up asked him about that hip pointer. He said it's fine now. He said he really didn't have much pain, but he said against Virginia you could tell he was in pain.
Here you can see the strategy. Take as many seconds as possible off the clock, then use the last 10 to 12 to initiate the offense. Got to keep Carolina away from a running game.
Keeping the ball in C.C. Harrison's hands, and he does hit this one, his first bucket of the night, and we're tied at 10. Wicker left open. That was for two.
Nobody guarding Surge at the top of the key, so you can't get the high-low going. Just shoots over the top of it.
Is that his first three-pointer of the year? His second. Actually, it was for two.
Well, it was a two-pointer. That was, he has one try from three this year. He's 0 for 1. But that was a two-point shot.
12:57 to play in the first half. It's Carolina by 2.
Surge showing his versatility, now wanting to bring the ball up the court.
He has fun playing, Billy. He was laughing at us. We were talking to one of the ball boys before the game, and he was laughing at us for talking to one of his boys.
One and done for Carolina, and Jim, I really think their strategy early on here should go inside, inside, inside. Those jump shots will be there later. They have such a big advantage inside, particularly with Jamison's tremendous ability in the low post.
draw with a turnaround jumper. Yes.
Turned against the body and hit it anyway. Nice screen. Excellent screen inside by NC State.
Touched by Strong. It'll be Carolina ball. Steve Norton coming into the ball game now for NC State. He'll replace Damon Thornton. Norton's a little bit bigger, 6'11", 250 pounds, and Thornton sits down with two personals.
And Norton only averaging 5 minutes a game.
Serge Swicker goes out of the ball game, Bill, excuse me, and Mokhtar Jai comes in. Jamison, sweet shot.
First two of the game were 8 minutes into the ball game, Tim. I mean, when you've got a player of that magnitude, he needs to touch it often and early.
14-12, Carolina. Looks like the old weave.
Old weave, right? You know, it's kind of interesting as to who puts the most pressure on the ball out front. Carter did a pretty good job. Jamison not doing a bad job going out there.
Hyatt for three. Right over top of Okalaja.
I really like the way he has developed his game over a period of time. Solid performer now.
Terrific high school football player.
Strong was as well. So.
Which really just shows their versatility. Carter looks pretty fresh tonight. This foul will be against Norton, his first.
What Steve Senek's trying to get done with Norton is just a couple of minutes on the clock so he can keep people fresh.
11:05 to play in the first half. It's NC State by one. We'll be back after this message from Bud Light. ACC basketball. Raycon Sports and Jefferson Pilot Sports sending along tonight the North Carolina NC State game to you. And it's a pretty good one so far. 11:05 to play first half, and it's NC State by one, 15-14. Clemson gets a big win in Cole Fieldhouse tonight, 67-63. Very well-disciplined team, very talented team, Clemson.
Former North Carolina player, Eddie Fogler, getting a win there. Georgia Tech up over Florida State. Of course, one other big score that didn't pop up there, the Wake Forest Virginia game. Be anxious to see how that one makes out. Virginia going to be a tough out.
Virginia was up by four with 8 minutes left at last check. Under 11 minutes to play first half.
Again, and here you see North Carolina kind of mirror imaging in regard to where their shot selection is, what NC State is trying to do. None of the ball going down and low. Jamison has touched it once and scored. First time tonight, a trap. Williams really doesn't put a lot of pressure out front, Tim. You notice that? He allows that ball handler to handle it and let the clock go down. He's got to occupy that ball handler earlier and force him to give it up.
Shot clock at 10, Billy. They're going to have to go. And they turn it over.
And get it back. There was a reach in there.
He's got to fly, though. It's 1 second on the shot clock. Buzzer goes off.
But a good handler.
Coda. Williams. Yes.
Great job by Coda pulling up, not forcing the ball down inside, gave him the passing angle he needed for that assist. That's why he leads the league.
Carolina by one. They're having fun at the Dean Dome tonight. 15 on the shot clock. Norton with a tough turnaround.
He's asked it to go down, and he's fouled. Nice looking shot over Jai. Terrific shot.
Mokhtar Jai called for the personal, his first.
You see the pass going in, handled well. Good turnaround. Excellent rotation on the shot. That's why he got the rim.
Chesting up, chesting up. Steve Norton, the 6'11 transfer from Furman. 250 pounds, 3 for 5 at the line.
Could you get a chest pointer doing that? I mean, if guys can get a hip pointer fall on the floor, they can get a chest pointer banging against each other.
Had one of those chicken bone chests.
That's right. You hurt somebody. Well, he scored less than 10 points the entire season before that play, so I guess you'd be looking for some help.
There it is, Billy. He's looking. He can jump it. It's there all game. And he's fouled.
Carolina has gone inside really three times with offensive moves. Jamison scored once and Zwicker scored twice. This game is not that complicated. Take what the opponent gives you.
Foul is on Danny Strong. Now is a great time to order Pizza Hut's new pepperoni pizza. Pizza Hut making it great again and again.
Tim Wells into the ball game now. NC State just trying to get some playing time out of people. Norton staying in there a lot longer than we anticipated. I thought he'd just go in there for a minute or two and give Thornton a chance to come right back in. He's playing pretty well.
Both teams shooting well, Billy. Zwicker has 7 points now. He only averages 11. Benjamin with the running one-hander gets it back. Norton again, strong inside. Has it blocked. Jamison. Poda.
Nice job by Jamison. Giving that ball up, setting up a perfect two-on-one break.
21-17, Carolina.
Now, if you're Poda, you want to force Benjamin to put that ball on the floor. Williams doesn't force anybody to put the ball on the floor. See, so it allows his clock to go off. He wants to, he ought to get right out there, and Dean Smith is telling him, get out there and double team, take the ball out of his hands.
Loud in the Dean Dome tonight. Benjamin for three. Yes!
Williams really not effective at all defensively in this ball game. Put pressure on a team, all five guys have to be doing it, or the one that isn't makes it really easy for the offense.
NC State 4 of 7 beyond the arc tonight. They trail Carolina by one.
Good thinking by Jamison. Nothing there, he didn't force it.
Penetration by Poda again. Shot clock at 6, bad shot. Poda seems to run the floor, run the team first, look for the shot second.
That's a little bit too quick a shot for the strategy NC State wants. Although in depth, I think they're about even. If you said, let these two second teams go against each other, it'd be a Mexican standoff.
His foul of Jeremy Hyatt. That's his second. Okalaja comes into the ball game, and Vince Carter will go out. He got some good minutes there.
I thought he not only got some good minutes, Tim, he didn't show any effects whatsoever of a leg as he did at the University of Virginia, I understand, the other night. He's really having problems getting around there.
Jamison at the line. 64% free throw shooting. This distance.
But Jamison has taken one shot at this point. It really not what you want if you're Carolina in a game like this.
Danny Strong comes in to replace Jeremy Hyatt. Jamison's going to get a little breather after this. .23 to play first half, 23-20 North Carolina. We'll be back after this message from Bell South. The Doctors of Heels, Surge's fan club, Serge Zwicker.
You know, Tim, those guys got some neat uniforms on it, but we've got a guy tonight I hope we show in this arena who's got the all-time uniform I've ever seen in a basketball arena. We'll catch him later. His mother had to work, what do you figure, the entire summer? He probably is the kind of guy that decided to come to Carolina when he's about 14 years of age. His mom started working on his outfit. It's an all-timer.
He looks like a Carolina Blue Sasquatch.
I don't know. You got to be a little hot in there, too.
It's hot in this building tonight.
Carolina goes full court pressure for the first time. State has an advantage of quickness. Let's see what happens.
Vasco Eftimoff is into the ballgame now. Here's Harrison. He pulls up for two.
Well, how often we see that? The most dangerous player on the floor is a guy's got the ball and everybody just left him go. Harrison so far tonight doing a good job.
Harrison with 4 points.
23-22 Carolina. Dangerous pass.
Shamon Williams left alone.
There he just had mirroring the other side. The most dangerous guy is the man with the ball.
Had a foot on the line, Billy. Two-pointer.
That being the worst shot you can take in basketball is a foot just on the line.
Not afraid to pull the trigger.
Well, if you've only had 9 points on the season coming in the game and you get your chance for a wide open shot, might as well put it up there. And he did make his first one.
Damon Thornton will check back into the ball game at center, replacing Norton.
Norton gave some quality minutes there.
He really did.
Wake Virginia, that Wake Forest team with a great deal of confidence when they play. Georgia Tech with a big win. State reminds me in this league a little bit like Minnesota in the Big Ten. You know, they just have problems, and you think they're getting some momentum, they don't seem to be able to win that big game.
Yeah, the way they started off, I thought, I was with you, I thought this is going to be a pretty good ball club.
And it is. It's a talented team. Thornton on a foul. Just happened to get under the body.
That's 17 fouls now, Billy, so it'll be 1-1. And that's 3 on Thornton.
Yeah, and that's not the kind of foul you want. Steve looks at him and just had him on the bench because of the two quick fouls. Tried to get some minutes out of Norton for him, and here he picks up his third in the matter of coming back into the ballgame for just seconds.
So now Tim Wells, the freshman out of Winston-Salem, comes into the ballgame to replace him. Okalaja at the line.
Coach Sindak telling him about the fact of have to be thinking. Freshman thinking about committing that foul down there. It was a totally unnecessary foul.
Okalaja, just a 50% free throw shooter, but that first one, nice form, nice touch, and the second one as well, all net.
Same was true with Jamison on that line. Here's that full court pressure again. Coach Smith trying to force the tempo of this game to be picked up. They don't want to play at half court at a time.
Carolina with its largest lead of the night, 5-27-22. Under 6 minutes to play first half.
I think we'll see as this game goes on, Dean Smith getting his guys to come out and double team on the ball. Here he is. He's doing it right now. Double team on the ball, force NC State to attack the basket quicker. Don't take off those 15 seconds. Now Williams have to do it likewise.
Shot clock down to 5. Harrison. Tough shot and hits it. Oh, wow. Falling away. Okalaja took his eye off of it for a second. Benjamin can't get it back, and Wells loops it out of bounds.
What we talked about at the top of the show, Tim, if you don't have an inside game, you got to score from the perimeter. The real key thing is not turning the ball over. And NC State this year is down 55 in the turnover assist ratio. You just cannot afford. You're not going to get that many chances inside for the cheap baskets. On the break, you've got to make them work.
Second turnover for NC State.
Good job by Strong.
And they lose it out of bounds. Cody gave it up, and State gives it right back.
Strong going on the floor with a good job, and then just can't hang on to it.
Vince Carter checking back into the ball game. He'll replace Ed Cota.
Come on.
We're going to get our first look at Justin Gainey for NC State as well. He's another talented freshman. Very quick, excellent defensive guard. He's gaining confidence, starting to shoot a little bit more. He replaces Oshawa Benjamin.
Cota goes over and sits down on that bench near Phil Ford, who was the first guy from Carolina to lead the ACC in assists. Phil did it for all 3 years that he had played here. Three of the four, rather.
Right? 27-24, Carolina. This is Shamon Williams over to Okalaja. Down to Jamison. Last touch by NC State.
We're really not seeing the ball go into the low post very well. That's why Jamison hasn't handled it. He's the guy who should be touching it.
Carolina hasn't effectively gotten it down inside to him. And we know how well Jamison can do when that ball goes out in the offensive flat. Probably as quick off the speed as anybody I've seen.
Inside they go to Zwicker. There he is.
Oh, Jamison then did it.
Okalaja gets it back and he's fouled. Okalaja's tenacious.
Yep. The entire game will break down if Carolina goes inside.
Nations Bank, a corporate partner of the Atlantic Coast Conference, presents this AC Salute to Excellence question. North Carolina's won the most ACC basketball championships with 13. What team is second? Billy Packer knows it. He's already shaking his head.
See if Okalaja has that same stroke he had the last time.
Over the back. I hear our friend Terry Gannon phoning in to answer that question.
You got to remember how the league started.
Right.
There was a guy named Everett Case.
That's exactly right.
Who won them all.
You know, it's going to be a shame, Billy, if they ever move out of Reynolds. And it looks like that new arena will become a reality eventually once they stop playing political ball with it.
Well, maybe once a year everybody go back in here and play some kind of a classic type thing.
They should.
And maybe before the season starts, some kind of exhibition type thing.
So much tradition in that building. You mentioned Everett Case, of course, Jim Valvano, and Doris Sloan. To play 27-24, North Carolina over State. We'll be back after this message from Bud Light. Couple of good ones coming your way. NC State takes on Clemson on Saturday. That game begins at noon. Third-ranked Clemson got a big win at Maryland tonight. Maryland takes on Wake Forest down in Winston-Salem Sunday at 4 o'clock. We were talking about the Carolina Sasquatch. Here he is, Billy, your guy.
Unbelievable, isn't it?
He cannot be warm. What do you figure, that's paper that he's got in that outfit?
I think it just looks like those pom-poms.
Oh, that's what it is.
Somebody was very creative with all the pom-poms they've gathered.
Or that, or he's dating a lot of cheerleaders.
Seven-24 North Carolina with 3:45 to play first half. Okalaja with a good first step to the baseline, dribbled into trouble, back to Williams.
Tim Jamison at this point in the game is 1-for-2. That's all he's touched it.
Nice pass into Zwicker. He couldn't handle it very well. And Okalaja with the follow.
And even though Zwicker didn't handle the pass, he just kept it up on the offensive glass where Carolina has all the advantage in his ball game.
Jamison with the steal, back to Kota, and he walks. Tried to do a little too much with it.
Well, he did, but he was put in a tough situation here. Jamison needed to give that ball up immediately, fill the lane, let the point guard handle it. The guy's inside the blue paint. He's really got to be a finisher there, not a passer.
North Carolina with 7 turnovers now.
Jamison out here on Benjamin.
3 minutes to play first half.
Benjamin moving now up to the front court. That's why there's that turnover. Here's the thing where Williams just doesn't put any pressure on the ball. And Dean Smith is waving to his players, come out and get it for pressure.
Another dangerous pass to Hyatt. 3 men up top. If they could get it down low, this is a double dribble. And the 6th turnover for the Wolfpack.
Well, nobody can fault Dean Smith. He's telling his guys what to do. They're just not getting out there and doing it.
The Nation's Bank ACC Salute to Excellence question. North Carolina's won the most. Who's won the second most? And, of course, NC State with 10 ACC tournament titles. Well, our call of the week is from last Saturday's Wake Forest Duke game. Ricky Peral with a shot here. Duncan works for the rebound, taps it twice before he gets control, and while being triple team, makes the move and gets the roll for 2 of his 26 points. That's our call of the week. Duncan finished with 14 rebounds, 8 of 14 field goals. Terrific player, and they won again tonight, beating Virginia.
inside.
Jamison.
Inside game. Good screening. First time Carolina really has gotten a good passing situation in a low post.
Carolina's largest lead, 31-24.
Strategy by Dean Smith now changing to get pressure on this ball. Even double jumping out with double teams.
Stay till trying to melt the clock.
Carolina would like to play a 40-minute game. State like to play 18 to 20-minute game.
Back to Gainey. Shot clock at 6. Jeremy Hyatt. Hyatt gets it back.
Left hand.
Left-hander.
Solid performance. Hyatt's the kind of guy who's developed himself into a guy that can play on any team in the league right now. Be a sub for a lot of people, but he'd be very solid.
Cuts the lead back to 5. 1.5 to play first half. Oh, Gainey almost makes the steal. Gainey gets his hands on a lot of balls, and they do get it back. Shamon Williams carried it out of bounds with him.
Williams, a funny player. He's really a two-guard that has a point guard size. You know, he's a good standstill open shooter. Really doesn't handle it that well and doesn't defend like a point guard.
That's a tough combination, though, Billy. You have point guard size and a shooter's mentality. Tough shot here. Can't get the roll, and Jamison pulls it down.
Think about Benjamin. The biggest game of his career was the first game he ever played in. Nice drive, and here's that scoring mentality.
Shamon Williams right down the lane. He has 12 points.
This a major stop for Carolina right here. Dean Smith up on his feet, trying to get his guys to get a double team and a run going.
They double team Norton. Throws it away. Here's Williams. 35 seconds, first half. Jamison. Strong play by Wells. To Harrison with his foot move. Yes.
You can see if State had an inside game, they've got some guys who could probably get out and run.
Very athletic team.
Yep.
33-28. Carolina will play for the last shot with 10 seconds to go in the half. Shot clock is off. 5 seconds. Carter.
Oh, it's it in.
He didn't call that one. He wanted that as a straight-in shot. It got away from him. And he gets a 3 anyway off the glass.
Banks it in at the buzzer and acts like, yes, sir. I called it.
No, that ball was definitely not aiming.
Yep.
He misjudged that one by about 2 feet. Got lucky.
Bam, bam.
Yeah, he pretended like I called that one all the way.
Yeah, little kiss. His first shot and makes a 3. So that's the end of the first half in Carolina with a 36-28 lead over NC State. Halftime activities next.
ACC basketball is being brought to you by Nationwide Insurance, by Fairfield Inn, and by BP.
Packer with you at the Dean Smith Center. Billy was screaming for the inside game of Carolina because of the mismatch there, and Carolina's points in the paint 14-6 over NC State right now, Billy.
And that may be statistically accurate, Tim, and I'm not questioning at all on that, but they still did not go inside right. Really enough, because the leading scorer in the first half is Williams. He's at 5 for 6 shots with 12 points. And Jamison, for a long period of time, only touched the ball inside twice. So when you really look at it, Herb Sundack probably is in a situation where he said, with the exception of that 3-point shot at the end, his team did what he wanted. He kept them in the ball game, except now he's got that 3-point shot hurt, as well as the foul trouble he has and what inside performance he does have on the floor.
Can Carolina shoot as well as he did in the first half?
Well, 61% is pretty difficult to duplicate, particularly against a team that's been holding its opponents to 39%.
Unbelievable, 61%. It's 36-28 Carolina. Cody with the rebound. Tar Heels with the ball.
That's a tough shot for your team to get an offensive rebound on.
Zwicker.
Second time tonight, Zwicker, and here's a push underneath. Going to be a cheap foul. And I would imagine you got to look to see if it was Benjamin committed the foul. That could be Thornton's fourth.
It's going to be on Strong. That's his fourth.
Yep, there's Strong pushing underneath. Good job by Jameson. That's his fourth. So Herb Sendak really has got a problem here. What inside power he did have, he's going to be sitting next to him.
You're losing a guy that can score, too. He's a streak shooter, but when he gets on, look out. So Tim Wells, the young freshman, comes in to replace him.
Really looking inside now.
Inside to go to Jameson. He's tied up by Harrison.
Dangerous pass. Not enough time of patience by Cota to let Jameson get open.
Because their scenario belongs to the Tar Heels. That is amazing. 61% shooting for Carolina. Doing what they have to do.
Well, there is a lot of pressure down inside by State, realizing they've got to block off the inside game.
Shot clock at 10. Okalaja kicks it out. Cota throws it away.
Cota so far this year at 12 assists against Southern Cal, 11 against Maryland, 7 against Arizona in the very first game he played. So he is an assist leader, but it's kind of difficult for him. You get down in that close. Zwicker, not the most nimble guy inside to catch that quick pass.
Out to Wells. Harrison. Quick shot. Big rebound by Okalaja.
Good, powerful rebound.
Coder's got good quickness, good ball handler, and inside it goes to Jameson. Shot by Jameson, and now the foul. I believe this will be against Harrison.
And then the game is over and easy for Carolina if they go in there.
It's on Wells. That'll be his first.
Watch how the quickness on the second put back by Jameson. There he is again. He's got the quickest bounce in college basketball.
First shot was off before he touched it.
Remember the one at Maryland to win the game last year? I mean, it was one of the great plays of the college season.
Labry on the floor, gets it up to Jameson. And misses the free throw. There's another guy that misses. Labry, although, you know, he was a senior,
a lot
he played
of experience.
A big role.
Yeah, he had a lot of experience he brought to the floor last year. I think back of these two teams, the year State won them both with Gugliotta having those incredible ball games, the two 99-point games that NC State had against the Tigers. And here's a great maneuver by Dean Smith to go ahead and double team out front to eliminate that business of taking time off the clock.
And Benjamin walks with it, trying to split the double team. 37-28. 9-point lead is their largest. Zwicker.
Good block out by NC State that time.
Great hustle by Okalaja. He stepped on the line, but boy, he gives you everything at both ends.
He does. He's a really aggressive player. He's come along extremely well. Bristol, you know, I mean, his game, he shoots the ball well. He handles it well for a man his size. He will rebound and defend. Williams picking up a little higher. I'm sure they talked to him about that during the halftime. Remember in the first half, he was just standing back, letting time go off the clock.
Harrison with a good first step and a little drop pass. And they get the roll by Thornton.
First time tonight that Thornton has showed us a little offensive move.
His first bucket of the night. Cuts the lead back to 7.
Well, we had Roy Williams here a little while ago. Thornton's best game was a 12 points, 10 rebound game against Kansas. And when you know Kansas' front line, you know how good a game that was.
Good hustle by everybody. Last touch by Harrison. Carolina will have it.
Now you can't fault either one of these teams in terms of the effort they're putting into the ball game.
A lot of contact.
Just not the talent level we've seen Carolina in State uniforms in years past. Great history of this league.
Here's Jameson, has a good look beyond the arc.
Secondary thought, wasn't it? He was looking to pass inside and then made up his mind to shoot.
You know, that's a good point, Billy, because a good shooter has to shoot in rhythm.
Exactly.
Once he hesitates, it just takes his shot away.
That's why you see even great shooters sometimes when they're looking inside and then all of a sudden realize they're not being guarded, have a hard time hitting that wide open jumper. Long rebounds there. Carolina taking much better advantage. That was a pretty good idea by Williams. He went to the body instead of the ball, hoping that he could shield it off, kind of like a guy going after a long pass.
Talking about the 61% shooting by Carolina, 0 for 5 this half. State just 1 for 3.
The play in this half is if they have a much bigger lead than they really have out there. You know, it wouldn't take it 1-3 to make this a close game again.
37-30 North Carolina, 16 and a half to play.
And everything is going to be double teamed out front, trying to force the tempo.
Shot clock down to 5. They've got to go. Benjamin off balance, backs it in, it'll go to the line. And 1.
Well, I really like this NC State game plan. And that time they worked it very effectively. You know, you really think that Benjamin probably makes more difficult shots than he makes easy shots.
Pointed out, his biggest game as a college player was the first game he played in against Prairie View. At 29 points, 7 for 8 threes. He was the leading freshman scorer in the ACC that year, over 14 a game.
And you know what, Billy, I think because of that performance in his first game, I think that elevated expectations, and it's been frustrating ever since.
I would agree with that. I mean, almost as if this is the next David Thompson. We've heard that so much. You know, the next David Thompson, the next Michael Jordan, and it really puts kids in a situation. That was said about Carter. He's going to be the next Michael Jordan. It really takes away from the real appreciation of what good things they do in a game.
37-33. And the foul. Yeah, and Carter had a very disappointing first year.
Yeah, and because the expectations are so high, we may never see the next David Thompson or the next Michael Jordan. It just may never happen. But it's certainly not going to automatically happen because some pundit says that this guy is going to be heat.
Antoine Jamison goes to the line. He's hit 51 of his 80 free throws this year. And hits that one. He had 19 points, 8 rebounds in the Virginia game last weekend. Amazing. And he's had 20 double-doubles in his 45 games here.
I mentioned the parallel between he and Tim Duncan. Tim Duncan seems to do it every game by the first half, you know. But he's staying right up there statistically with the best player in the country.
He makes it a 39-33 Carolina lead.
And how long will State be patient? Well, the object is to keep this game close as long as they can. Sometimes you look up that score and get frustrated and start taking bad shots.
So far they're blown, they start to move it quickly.
So far they're staying with the game plan very well.
Shot clock down to 15 as they continue to melt it. Harrison, nice move.
Beautiful. Got some mismatches there when they play on that perimeter. That time it was Jamison who was taking advantage of.
Lob pass inside. Jamison, the last to touch it. Carolina does not have a field goal here in the second half. The lead is 4. We'll be back after this message from Bud Light.
Here was D. Harrison on that good drive. We talked about some mismatches. Jamison really not quick enough to stay with a guy that actually can play on the perimeter as well as any guard. He's got 10 points, had 8 points in a win 2 years ago against North Carolina.
Last year, Carolina inexperienced in the front court. This year, inexperienced in the back court.
Now they go to a zone with Jamison running down on the baseline.
Hyatt left alone and gets the roll.
Be quite honest with you, this should play a little bit into State's hands. Less pressure on the ball. Jamison takes his eye off it.
Carolina looking for its first field goal in the second half. Get it back here.
Nice teamwork by the officials.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah.
Dick Paparo wasn't sure. Called in for help. And David Ellicott saw it.
You see that NC State handling the ball much better, as we pointed out in that first half. Had 11 big turnovers. When you're trying to play a possession game, you can't afford to do that. Doing much better here in the second half.
1 point, Carolina lead. Okolaja,
not a good shot.
Brick,
wasn't even thinking shot on that play.
Harrison pulls up and scores right over top of Carter.
Now here, Tim, the pressure goes in the other direction. Carolina, with that mental pressure we talked about at the top of the game, not the physical, but the mental, start looking up at that scoreboard, and they've got to just keep their mind on what they're supposed to be doing, which is getting the ball down low.
NC State with a 1-point lead, 14 and a half minutes to play. Jamison out of control, loses it.
Nothing there at all.
Herb Senek tells State to slow it down.
Now he goes to the 1-4 offense now down low. Now Carolina showed a zone for just one time down the floor. Obviously, they can't stay in the zone because that plays into State's hands. Dean Smith wants a double team out front on the ball. Beautifully executed by State. A solid screen. Did you see that play? Very well done.
Reset the shot clock. State gets it back.
Now James Carter screaming at his teammates. Look for a breakdown mentally here if you're NC State. Ball should have been intercepted.
Harrison starts
a rebound.
And the follow by Thornton, and he's fouled.
What a rebound by Thornton. Excellent hands.
Boy, he is an excellent athlete. Excellent leaper.
Good move inside. Watch Thornton come through, grab it down, left hand, put it back up. Spicker gets called for the foul, just a touch foul there. But there's where you look for if you're the opponent. You signs of cracking.
Damon Thornton, a 54% free throw shooter, 6'8", 230-pound freshman.
Those that watch the Maryland-Clemson game, one of the things you like about Clemson's team is that they just have that patience about them when the game gets tight. Wake Forest, very similar to that. You never see any expression. You just, you know, look like a warrior just going to stay with you and beat you in the end. But when a team is under the pressure Carolina is, you know, you look for some cracks.
Clemson in the past has that occasional breakdown during a ball game or a little lapse. They have not had that this year. Excellent. Well-coached ball club. NC State by two. Carolina still looking for its first field goal of this half.
State playing tough defense right now.
Wicker's not close with his shot. Harrison's starting to feel it. Playing with a lot of confidence.
Now let's see. With Harrison out of the top, here you are for almost 7 minutes, Carolina, without a field goal. Now you start thinking about Maryland. You know, how is it possible? You're playing solid ball game, and then all of a sudden it just evaporates.
13-3 run by NC State. Carolina shot 61% from the field in the first half. Stone cold now. That's a walk by Harrison.
Well, it's difficult when you're trying to execute and get a good shot with just 7 seconds on the clock. One of the things I'd be anxious to see if State goes back to that solid screen against that double team and get that shot on the wing. Benjamin missed it the last time, but it certainly was a well-executed play.
Really, as loud as it was in this building, it's quiet now. Here's Carter.
Hard for the fans to get excited when their team has not scored a field goal in now almost 8 minutes.
And shots aren't even close, hitting hard.
And they're not getting anything on the break. It's just an easy basket to break this thing open a little bit. As a walk that time, Norton got away with it.
I agree with you. It was a walk, but he was smart. He was close. They put it on the
wall. He dribbled.
Okalaja checks in. Carter will go out.
I don't think Norton himself expected to be out the top of the key dribbling the ball in this game.
Carter showing signs of a limp now. As he goes and takes a seat on the bench.
Well, he wasn't limping when he hit that three-pointer.
Oh, he wasn't. At the end of the first half. Benjamin takes it to the paint. Fires Thornton!
What's happening now? Because Carolina can't put man-to-man one guy on the dribbler pressure and need two, that opens up somebody for the NC State team. If you can't control the dribbler with just one man, you have a problem.
NC State with its largest lead, 43-39. Here's Williams.
He won't. He turns it over. And Dean Smith calls for a 20-second timeout, and he really needs it.
11:32 to play in the ballgame. NC State leads 43-39. And North Carolina still looking for a field goal. Thornton, bingo.
Here we're going to see the double teaming. Good job by Benjamin. Breaks the double team, goes right on through. And as I said, if two are guarding one, somebody has to be open. That time it was Thornton, and he put it away.
Isn't that the truth? The old adage you learn early in this game. Two men on me, somebody's got to be free.
Absolutely. And all of that breaks down, Jim, because what Dean Smith has had to do is to create a two-on-one trap because he doesn't have anybody going out putting one-on-one pressure on the man with the ball.
Well, the Blues Brothers performing during that timeout, trying to get the crowd back in.
I think the crowd has been fine, particularly considering the fact that their team has not scored a field goal in almost 8 minutes.
A little over 8 minutes. Better get it in. Hyatt calls a timeout, wants 20 seconds. Couldn't get the ball in bounds. I've never understood that, how you can't get the ball in bounds.
Well, it's a smart move, though, by Hyatt. That possession is really important here with the lead. Don't want to give it up just like a turnover.
Advance Auto Parts, proud to be a corporate donor to the Juvenile Diabetes Foundation. Over the past few months, Advance Auto Parts stores throughout the southeastern region of the United States have raised over $600,000 to fight the disease. Advance Auto Parts and the Juvenile Diabetes Foundation, together walking for the cure.
You know, Tim, when we think of NC State, the game against Memphis. You were talking about to me before this ball game. You know, Memphis have one of the strange teams in America. I think they scored 11 points the first half against Tennessee in a loss at in Knoxville. They turned around a couple weeks later and beat Michigan on a neutral floor. So that's got to be a pretty solid win there. So these kids have tasted some success. Full court pressure by Carolina.
State ended Memphis' 33-game home streak with that win, too.
And nobody guarding the man out of bounds. Surprised nobody's going to set a solid screen here for Benjamin. He has to beat Cota by himself.
To play in the game. There's a clock problem, and Herb Sendick is not happy about the delay.
Well, if I were Herb, I'd kind of like this in a way. Because Carolina was all fired to come out with a full court press. This gives his kids a chance to look over the floor a little bit.
Well, that delay was all for 1 second.
And I always think the best play against this kind of press is to have a man. The best play against that kind of press is to step a man out of bounds, throw the ball to him, and just step back in bounds and get it. Whenever your man is not being guarded, that's taking the ball in bounds, it's a simple way to always get it in bounds. And I don't understand why that became so difficult.
Nor do I, but it's a 5 second call and a turnover, and Carolina gets it back.
Very poor execution by NC State.
Tar Heels trailing by four.
Particularly when you had that much time to see what defense was deployed against you.
This is one-on-one. Williams and Harrison.
Harrison doing a pretty good job with him when he uses the dribble.
Inside the go, Norton taps it away.
Boy, Cota, he telegraphed the pass. I mean, Jamison is active inside. You don't have to just throw that ball in there like that. Here comes the double team again. Great job by State.
Harrison, yes!
That will not work. Maybe occasionally double teaming, but that will not work as a steady diet. State's reacting to it.
Amazingly, North Carolina still has no field goal this half. Okalaji with a strong rebound. Hyatt ties him up. That possession arrow belongs to the Wolfpack.
What we see right now is NC State gaining confidence with every possession, and the Carolina guys looking around like, what's going on? You can see Carter out here now talking to his teammates. Disgruntled looks on his face. See, the pass was telegraphed. Norton, one guy that does have height advantage. If Carolina goes back, the State goes to the 1-4. Nice job on their part. Carolina can't put pressure on the ball when it's one-on-one.
Jeremy Hyatt actually talking to Okalaja. He looks over to see if there's a count. There is still none. Hyatt turns it over. Yep. The point of emphasis this year to watch for palming the ball. Too many guys with the crossover using the palm to control the ball.
You know, they had so much more success not using Hyatt in that position. They're taking turns who goes out up top. Williams wants his jump shot.
Okalaja. Still no field goal. Big rebound inside. And Carter with the foul.
Carter very demonstrative.
So is Steve Norton, the transfer from Foreman. Furman, rather. Looked like a Foreman on that play.
Here you see him using that body inside. We're talking about a guy who has scored a total of 9 points coming in this game the whole year. Getting a lot of quality minutes. Strong on that bench.
9 points for Jamison. He averages 22.
Here's Carolina back in the zone. This will merely help State occupy the ball with no pressure out front.
Shot clock at five. Patterson recognizes with a good pump fake.
Out of the pass.
And they don't get the shot off. Harrison made the good move, should have gone with the shot.
Now, we have, I think, a difference of opinion by the two referees.
Zwicker's checking his teeth. Higgins took a shot with the chops.
The violation happened before the foul.
Violation before the foul. Dean Smith wants another 20-second timeout.
Wicker still checking his teeth. He must have really taken a pretty good hit to the mouth. The shot clock violation occurred before the foul. We've got 9:17 to play. 46-39 NC State over Carolina. Hey, coming up this weekend, NC State takes on the Clemson Tigers, ranked number 3 in the country. Got a big win at Coldfield last night. That game Saturday at noon, and it will be followed by the Maryland Terrapins at Wake Forest Sunday at 4 p.m. Check your local listings for some outstanding games this weekend.
Here we see the shot inside. That one is one that Harrison should have put up. You know, Tim, just keep it alive because he had good... There he goes. Norton hit Zwicker right in the nose, right? The bridge in the nose, anyway.
All right, this is Carter with the ball.
Orton running down inside on Jamison.
Williams off the back of the iron. Turnover, this is Benjamin.
And one, boy, did he take off on that play.
And Benjamin
drive.
Banks it in. Do you believe this? 48-39 NC State.
No, I do not. I said in that first half, Carolina should go down inside often and early. They didn't want to do that, and now they want to do it, and it's hurting.
And the foul outside. Billy, we talked about the players that have left here at Carolina, but let's be honest here. There's some talent on that floor for the Tar Heels.
Yeah, there's some talent, but it's not the same as putting out there Rasheed Wallace. I mean, you know, you just changed the whole ball game. You put Rasheed Wallace and Jerry Stackhouse and McGinnis in the game. I mean, you forget about strategy. What we have now is not only the talent, but as I said at the top of the show, you have the mental aspect that this talent is under right now. They're feeling a lot of pressure.
Well, it's a young club. That's one thing. I mean, now it's basically a freshman and sophomore team.
Believe me, kids read newspapers, and when they see they're the first team in the history of a school to ever start off a season 0-3 in a league in the ACC. I mean, you read that. And just like last year, not making it to the Sweet 16, you read about those things. And it works on them.
This is Jamison.
Now guys aren't even looking at the rim.
Williams looked at it. Here's Okalaja.
He's got it.
And he hits the three.
Nice follow here. Big, big shot. Is there a foul after the play?
Adamola Okalaja has now hit 23 of his 54 three-point attempts.
Well, Hyatt got hurt, but he doesn't want to come out of this ball game.
Looks like his hip.
He didn't want to come out. He wanted to stay on the floor.
He's up in that area where they have hip corners. They're going to freeze it and try to get him back in the ball game.
Carolina. Not playing into a zone situation.
Well, that's what I was talking about earlier. Football, they wear hip pads. Much more vulnerable in the game of basketball with all the banging that takes place here in the 90s. Their hips are uncovered.
Tougher to get this shot off down the clock against this zone.
Shot clock at three. They've got to fire.
Good rebound by Stifler. State has got to attack differently if Carolina's going to be in the zone.
This will be Carolina ball. They're melting the clock, but the last two trips, they haven't gotten a good look at the basket.
Well, it's very difficult because you can't go one-on-one against the zone like they do against the man-to-man.
7:23 to play. We've got a ball game. We'll be back after this message from Bud Light. NC State leading North Carolina by six with 7:23 to play here at the Dean Dome.
Tim, that's a 20-6 turnaround here in the second half. Memories of the Maryland situation.
Smith's four-game losing streaks. Well, he's only had two of them. Maryland's been involved in both of those streaks.
Well, 92. Remember who won the national championship in 93?
Sure do. Carolina.
So they had a streak the year before they turned around and won it all. And here's where we see the difference in this ball game. Something where North Carolina should have a huge advantage of not scoring a point in the paint in the second half.
Okolodjo dribbles on the baseline into trouble and throws it backboard. Serge Wicker was a member of that national championship team as a redshirt player in 93. You know, it's interesting, Billy. Carolina averaged only 39% from the field in their three losses. And I guess if you shoot that poorly, you're going to lose. But what amazes me about this second half performance is they shot 61% of the first half.
Yeah, Tim, but as I pointed out there, they were making their shots but not running their offense. And sometimes that is one of those statistical nightmares for a coach. Say, hey, remember how long it was before Jamison touched the ball. Two shots for most of the first half. Nobody blocking out. Ball comes right inside. Easy putback, doesn't happen.
So Harrison is fouled by Williams. He goes to the line with 7:04 to play.
That's the first thing you can fault Harrison for not doing right tonight. He's had a fine ball game.
Kirk Sendak getting some good minutes out of Steve Norton. And C.C. Harrison hits his first. Jeremy Hyatt on the bench with an injury. Looks like he got that hip bruised.
Well, I think we'll see him back in here very shortly.
Well, I agree. You get an injury like that, the worst thing you want to do, though, Billy, is sit around and let it tighten up on
you. Well, you pointed out that they did put that freeze on there, so maybe he doesn't even feel it by now. State staying with a hard-nosed man-to-man. There's Williams. That's what he wants to do.
Yeah, Williams gets the good look, and he drains it.
That's the first real look he's had in the second half of the shot.
His first basket this half, and it cuts the lead to five.
And Carolina stays in the zone. Thornton quicker inside than his Vicker, and takes advantage of it.
David Thornton with a turnaround.
He's picking up confidence. That's his third big play here in the second half.
He's right at his average, 6 points. Better ball movement now for Carolina. That ball was halfway down, came back out.
And Williams really has the mentality of a scorer. And again, that doesn't help Jamison at all.
Understand we had some weather problems up in Virginia and Maryland. Get that freezing rain up there. We had some technical problems. We're back now. It's 5:52 to play in the ball game, and NC State leads North Carolina 52-45. Carolina has really struggled offensively here in the second half.
See, Williams has no chance against Harrison. Harrison just eats him alive.
Here's Williams at the other end.
Two players still down, Williams still on the floor, so it's a 5-on-4 situation.
Good pull up here, though, to melt the clock. The clock is really the factor here.
A well-coached game here in terms of the theory as to how NC State wanted to play this game.
Well, Benjamin walks. Second time he's walked here in this half.
Now, Benjamin and Thornton going after each other a little bit. Thornton feeling he was open. team will start looking at the scoreboard first. Can NC State play with this lead, and can Carolina come from behind?
Well, Billy, you mentioned it. I think Carolina's going to feel more of the pressure. Here's Okalaja with a nice shot.
That's a great job by Jamison getting up on the board.
That cuts the lead to 7. Herb Sendek wants a 20-second timeout.
I like the confidence in which he called that timeout. Like, hey, guys, let's not lose sight of what we're trying to accomplish here.
4:53 to play. Forget this weekend, we have a couple of good games for you. First on Saturday at noon, NC State travels to Clemson. The Tigers having their best year ever, ranked 3rd in the nation, picking up a big win at Cole Fieldhouse tonight. Then on Sunday at 4 o'clock, the number 11 team in the nation takes on number 2, Wake Forest. The Terps are in the middle of their best season in 20 years. Heartbreaking loss tonight to Clemson, but Wake Forest on a roll, comes back to beat Virginia. That game at 4 p.m. So check your local listings. ACC basketball right here on Raycom Jefferson Pilot Sports.
Cota does a much better job than Williams defensively out front against that ball. Now they're back into that zone as the clock winds down. They're going to get off a jump shot here.
Shot clock at 7. They've had 2 shot violations already this half. Danny Strong, too strong.
Strong had to be prepared to shoot that shot, knowing it was down to 4 seconds.
Carolina making a little bit of a run here. Here's Okalaja. Jamison.
Nice blockouts inside.
And good hustle by Cota to get it back, but he stepped on the line.
You see the Carolina kids with their hands on their heads there? Very demanding. Instead of saying, hey, let's get back on defense here, couple of inches there, teammate steps out of bounds, can't help that.
Jamon Williams ran to the scorer's table and tried to get in before the ball was back in play.
17% in the second half. Unbelievable. Thornton looked up at the, as if he was going to take that outside jumper.
Nice. He walked, Thornton, and he walked.
Good give-and-go situation, but a big walk.
3:39 to play. NC State holding on, 54-47. We'll be back after this. Serge Wicker coming back on the court, trying to get everybody fired up here. Carolina trailing 54-47 with 3:39 to play in the ballgame.
And Tim, the other thing that used to be a big advantage for Carolina at this point in the game is they've worn the other team down with their bench. Primarily what we're seeing is a 6-man squad right here. And so these guys really are going to have to suck up some energy.
Colin Williams for the wraparound. Bill, you mentioned the psychological part of the game. You know there are people in this arena, too, that are starting to think, oh, for 4, can that happen?
Well, it can happen. It just doesn't happen here. That's
doesn't happen very often.
You got to remember, in the history of this league, there's only one team, and I'm knocking Florida State out of this because they just came in the league in 91. There's only one team that never finished last place, and that's Carolina. Everybody else has had their day in last place.
Fouled by Serge Wicker, and he's fouled. Fouled by Thornton, and that will be his 5th.
So Thornton out, Norton in. And they played right at Zwicker inside. He did an excellent job not committing the foul himself. Look at this. 2 men on Zwicker down inside. He just holds his ground and comes up with a beautiful block and then retention of the ball.
So the foul is on Strong, and that is his 5th.
So Strong with more experience out of there. If you're NC State, you'd probably rather have Strong on the floor and Thornton with his 5th.
But Thornton still has foul trouble as well.
Off the foot of Okalaja. Nice job that time. Jeremy does a good job staying right there with him and not giving up the baseline drive.
3:04 to play. NC State trying to hold on.
Full court pressure here. Trying to hit the free man. Good job by Hyatt. In
They're trying to melt the clock, though. NC State can't get out of its offense. They've been called for two shot clock violations already. This foul is on Williams.
Boy, he was playing solid defense. If he doesn't reach in there, that's the best defense he's played until he reached in there on that play.
That'll be three on Williams. NC State number one, scoring defense.
Well, you got to remember, when you take that in consideration, you got to remember Winthrop 28 points, Pine Brook, Arkansas 23, and Pan Am 25. So those three games there that actually had a player outscore the entire team.
Yeah, Harrison outscored right. Pine Brook.
So that really is a misnomer.
Big bucket by Harrison there.
Again, Williams was used defensively.
Pushes the lead back to nine. Harrison with 21 points.
Not where you want Jamison shooting the ball. Norton Hawks. Well, again, great effort, though. We talked about the number of minutes that he's played in this ball game has to shock the NC State faithful. Jamison 0 for 7 the first half, and I'm going to say that that goes back, I mean, in the second half, I'm still going to say that goes back to the first half when he didn't touch it early. He never got into a sync as to how to get Jamison the ball where he likes to handle it.
Smart play by Williams. Couldn't get it in, didn't want the violation, and threw it off the leg of Harrison. Loses it again.
Benjamin with good quick hands on Williams. They can't get the ball out to be in an offensive position to make the feed.
Big rebound, though.
Thornton has had a really good second half here. There's a steal. Williams, yes. Benjamin fell backwards. Good job by Jamison.
56-49 with 1:53 to play.
Ooh, Williams has to be careful. Want to slam that ball down. Here comes another timeout by State to try to settle things down. You tell me there isn't some tension here in this ball game?
NC State trying to become the 23rd school in NCAA history to top the 1,300 win mark. 1:50 left to play. We'll return after this message from the Atlantic Coast Conference. A minute 50 to play at the Dean Dome. 56-49, NC State over Carolina. Carolina trying to hold on, or they're going to go 0-4 in the ACC.
Tim, now you have to start thinking about Dean Smith extending the length of this ball game. We said in the beginning he wanted to play 40 minutes. Now he'd like to play 20 minutes here in the last minute and 50 seconds. We're going to see some fouling, trying to go for the steals. NC State is a 65% free throw shooting team. Herb Sendak's going to be dying with free throws right now. Does his team make them or miss them?
Herb Sendak's done a marvelous job melting the clock, using the clock, keeping the game close until the second half. And their largest lead was 9.
I would have said this is a good time to try to go long. And a bad play. Because it wasn't set up to go long.
Hyatt's had trouble getting the ball in this evening. Williams, this is the 3. Yes!
And he turns and looks over this way instead of concentrating on the game.
56-52, NC State. Another turnover.
Williams again, finding. He wants that shot.
Tar Heels. Knocked out by Benjamin, but the Tar Heels still have the ball.
Williams wants the shot, Tim.
Zwicker comes back into the ball game.
For Williams. He's trying to get himself open.
Back to Jamison, who has a look from 3.
Good rebound by Benjamin.
And a possession arrow belongs to Carolina.
Now, what's happening now? Carolina sending 5 guys to the boards. trying to overplay every inbounds pass. UC State could take the gamble and send somebody long to try to get an easy basket. Before, they had a chance to go long, but they didn't set up the play. 61 seconds left in the ball game, and NC State still leads by four. Timeouts they've got left in this situation. You don't want to have to give up possession with the arrows if you can get it. You see timeouts left right here, 20 seconds. Both of them are out of them. But there's one more full timeout for State. Carolina's got two. Oh, a lady that's dying as well, huh? And they said Dean Smith knows how to extend a game at the end as well as any coach that's ever sat on the sidelines.
Billy, Carolina's showing more confidence right now down this stretch than we've seen the entire second half.
Well, I think the emotional juices are really flowing right now. They can't be thinking about the problem they're in. They just got to go play, and it's helping them here. And maybe State starts thinking about it.
61 seconds left. NC State leads by four. Carolina with the ball.
Don't need three-point shots here. Unless you get the wide open look.
Williams has had the hot hand. And he has the ball.
And you know what he's thinking.
55 seconds left. Inside they go to Jameson. Tough shot!
Where was that in the first half, huh? Benjamin's got an opening, and there's the foul.
This foul is on Okalaja. Going to center the line with 27 seconds left.
Coach Smith did not want the foul. He wants solid defense there. There's plenty of time on the clock. You don't want to give NC State any easy points. Here is a play that was available this entire ballgame. One-on-one low for Jameson.
NC State has one timeout left. Carolina has two. Benjamin's going to the line.
68% free throw shooting. Those free throws will be tough coming down the wire.
40 seconds left.
Plenty of time to go to Jameson again inside.
Williams is fouled by Benjamin. He'll go to the line. It's 1-1.
Now here's the situation. In the time that these two teams have played, 60 games have been decided by 5 points or less, all right? And you're going to have no shot clock on for NC State, but they've had all kinds of problems getting the ball inbounds. So they could be in a situation here with a tie ball game and possession. And they could hold the ball down for that last second shot. Excellent free throw here.
Carolina's first trip to the line. Williams hits it, and it's a one-point game.
As Vicker out and Mary in, meaning that Dean Smith probably going to go to some kind of full-court pressure here.
What a story Charlie McNary is. A walk-on, one of three seniors on this club.
And NC State going to take their last timeout? A little dangerous there. I think you'd like to have one left. Isn't that their last timeout?
That's the last timeout, Billy, but I think Sendek felt it was imperative to talk to them, to talk about the options. If he makes this shot, they get it back with 31 seconds left.
Let me ask you a question. When did basketball practice start? October 15th. Don't you work on situations, you know? Because that timeout, you may need it. The guy gets hung up in the situation. You want to stop the clock in some way, shape, or form? Or you want to set up that last second shot with
you? I don't disagree with you, but you'll have to know your team.
I understand.
ACC Basketball was brought to you by Food Lion, by Bud Light, by Nations Bank, by Pepsi, and by Advance Auto Parts.
The announcers for
this game selected and compensated by Raycom and Jefferson Fireless Sports. Any use of this broadcast without their express permission is prohibited.
Now you've got it. Best free throw shooter in the team on the line. Chance to tie this thing up.
31 and a half seconds left. It's 56-55 NC State. Williams at the line.
As we said, the total number of points he scored all season with 9 coming into the ballgame.
And out of those 5, he's made 3 of them.
Here's why coaches go.
He's played well tonight. Coming back from knee surgery, transfer from Furman, has not gotten many minutes before this ballgame. Norton is 0-for-1 this evening.
To get a 3 to tie even if the free throws go.
Carter almost got a technical when the timeout was called. He slammed the ball to the floor. It went up almost to the ceiling, and Dean Smith looked over at the officials, Dick Paparo, and said, all right, it's okay. We know. He's all right. Carter hits the first.
Now, here's why I said you need that other timeout, Jim, because now you really have a situation. Your guys have to know how to get it in bounds, and if you're NC State, you got to be thinking 3. Who takes it? Who handles it?
Carter has now hit 33 of his 35 free throws this year.
So he and Williams, two guys you had on the line at the end of the game, just exactly who you want there.
59-56, Tar Heels. 8 seconds left.
He's got to go for the 3. Carolina out there. There's Benjamin's got it. Took too much time to get it off.
Less than a second left. Carolina is going to get its first win in the conference this year. And the Tar Heels want timeout.
Well, they snatched victory from defeat, didn't they?
Unbelievable, Billy.
It was unbelievable how they got in such a position there after shooting 60% the first half, had a 20-6 run go against them to start the second half.
But you mentioned how Dean was a curator of clocks down the last couple minutes. He extended this game, got his club on the run, went from 4 down to 3 up.
Here we see Jameson setting up in the low post. Carolina gets it to him. Exactly the man you want touching the ball. Here we can see Benjamin had to be ready to take the shot right away. He dribbled into trouble. He had to know that there was a 3. He had about 3 seconds at that point and needed a 3-point play. Needed to set up inside the 3 line, outside the 3 line and take it.
Our MVPs for the game, Food Line, will make a $1,000 donation on their behalf to the ACC's Operation Outreach Fund, which benefits deserving middle schools throughout the ACC region. Harrison with 21 points, 2 assists, and Okalaja with 7 rebounds, 9 points.
And there you're going to see an intentional foul. Hyatt grabbed Jameson's shirt, and that should be intentional. Without question, it should be intentional.
You can't grab a man's shirt to impede his progress.
'59-56 North Carolina.
Doesn't make much difference one way or the other as to what it is, because the game for all intents and purposes is over. Crazy things have happened.
So James then at the line just trying to put an exclamation point on this one.
Dean Smith wants no one on the line. And he's wanting Jamison to miss the shot.
That's it. Carolina comes from behind to beat NC State 59-56. What a turnaround, Billy.
Amazing basketball game for a lot of reasons.
Well coached at both ends. Antoine Jamison. There was a huge play down the stretch. Once again, the final score, North Carolina 59, NC State 56. North Carolina goes to 1-3 in the conference. You've been watching exclusive coverage of ACC basketball on the Raycom, the Jefferson Pilot Sports Network. For Billy Packer, I'm Tim Grant. So long, everybody.